Hi friends, in this short video I'm going to show you how you can add focus state to your component library in Figma. I came across this method when I was working with Atlassian design system, so all the credit goes to them. I think this method is very clever and I've really been enjoying using it over the past few months. As an example here, I have a couple of components that we'll be testing this on: a button, a toggle, and a breadcrumb. We'll be creating focus state as its own utility type component. We'll begin by creating a frame. And this frame truly doesn't matter which width and height you give to it. But then from here, we're going to remove the fill and we will add a stroke instead. You can apply whichever color you want your focus state to be. Typically, it's like a bright blue color. We can also increase the width to 2 pixels. And give a border radius of 4. Now I'm going to rename this to focus frame. I'm also naming it this way with a dot in front of it because I assume that it is going to be a hidden component, but maybe you decide to keep it visible, not just inside your design system file. And in that case, you can do something like this. This way it will get published. So now we're going to turn this into a component. And it's ready to be used. Let's start by applying this to our button component. Right now, we have a couple button variants here. First, we have different types, a secondary, a primary, and a saddle. And then we also have states for default and hover. What I'm going to do now is copy our default states once. And we're going to move them all the way to the bottom. Let's change state from default to focus. Now I'm going to grab an instance of our focus ring and we're going to paste it into our first button. Since this button is made with auto layout, the auto layout does get applied to the focus state as well. And we don't want that. So what we're going to do is add absolute positioning to it. And now we're going to move it to wherever we want it to be. From here, you can play around with like how much offset you want the focus state to have. So for example, you can have it very close or have some space between button edges and the focus ring. And typically, I think having a little bit of offset makes the focus state much more clear. Now let's test our button. So there are a couple things going on here. First is that I'm trying to click to edit the button text, but I can't, because the focus ring gets in the way. And to fix this, you can either change the layer order by moving the focus ring up to the top. And now you can click to edit your text, or you can also lock the layer. And this will also fix this issue. But now let's try to type a longer label. And as you can see, our button is resizing as expected, but then our focus state isn't. What we're going to do is we'll return to the variant and I'm going to set the constraints from left to left and right. And now no matter what your button label is, the focus ring is going to resize together with it. Now that we've tested our focus ring with one button variant, we can copy it and then we can select our other focus variants, paste. And now the focus ring is applied to those variants as well. In general, I think it's a good idea if you have multiple variants of the same thing, like we have with the buttons here, is to add a modification, or in our case, it's the focus ring, to one variant first, and then test it to make sure that it has all the properties, all the constraints that you want it to have, and then apply it to the other variants. Now that we've applied this to our button, we can do that with our toggle and our breadcrumb, just to look at a couple more examples. So first, I'm going to copy our two toggles, and we're going to move them to the bottom, change the state to focus. Then we'll take an instance of the focus ring and then paste it inside our toggle. Since our toggle is not made with auto layout, it's not going to paste the focus ring into some weird position. It is just going to the center, more or less. So from here, we can adjust it however we would like. First, we're going to make it rounded. And we can also make it smaller. And once you've adjusted that for one variant, you can paste it into the remaining variants. And in our case, it's just one other one. To wrap it up, let's add a focus state for our breadcrumb. So I'm going to copy the default state. State is going to be focus. We'll grab an instance of the focus ring, paste it inside, and since our breadcrumb is made with auto layout, it's going to just snap as the next item in the auto layout order. We're going to set it to absolute positioning, and now it no longer respects the auto layout settings. And we're going to make it smaller. And again, when we test it, first we want to make sure that we can click inside our text. So what you can do is either bring it to the top and or lock it. And then just like we did with our button, we want to make sure that the constraints are set to left and right. And then maybe not in the case of the breadcrumbs, but maybe if you have some other text or some other component that can resize not only horizontally, but also vertically, something like this. You would also want to make sure that your focus ring has vertical constraints set to top and bottom. Anyway, that's it. Again, I really like this method because first it allows you to control the focus state from one place. If I wanted to change color to something else or change thickness, I can just do it in one place. And also it does allow you to create this offset effect, which you can do with strokes. I will leave the link to this file in the description. However, I definitely suggest that you check out the ADS components file by Atlassian because it's an example of a complete component library that uses this focus ring method. Thank you for watching, and until next time, bye-bye.